and Zemary Ortega.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Amara Jacqueline, and with me are our co-authors, Zemary Ortega and Diana Mejorada. We would also like to take this opportunity, of course, to thank our research advisor, Dr. Melba Tanaco, and our research mentor is Maria Teresa de la Rosa. The research paper that we are about to present is entitled Experiences of Male Individuals Committing Domestic Violence Against Women and Children in Davao City. For our background, eradicating domestic violence against women and children has been a long journey and a battle, not only here in the Philippines, but for the entire world. And this is why, just recently, last March 8th of 2018, we have celebrated the International Women's Day. This is because we celebrate the numerous laws, the crafted programs and services for our women and children. However, given the success that we have achieved with the said sectors, little to nothing has been done to comprehend and understand the perpetrators of violence, or what we should call them, doers of violence. And so, our study focuses on the experiences of the doers of violence.
For our theoretical framework, we use the lens or utilize the lens of the ecological systems theory developed by Irene Barker-Berner, a Russian-American developmental psychologist. With this theory, we can have a holistic view of the client situation, given that it has five systems, namely micro, macro, meso, exo, and the program system. And now it already branched out to another system, which is the gene system. Then, also, we could also be helped in identifying the factors and triggers of why the doers of the violence commit such violent act. Also, we could have an understanding, and we could also analyze and determine better ways in helping them. For our statement of the problem, we have one more question. How do male individuals committing domestic violence against women and children perceive their experiences of perpetration? Under it, we have three sub-questions. First is, what are their experiences during their childhood years, specifically in the family setting and the community setting? Second question is, what are their experiences of commission prior, upon, and after? Lastly, what are their experiences of prosecution, intervention, and services intended for the doers of violence? For our significance of this study is significant to the general public, the Department of Social Welfare and Development, to the Integrated Gender and Development Division of Davao City, the Talikala, the policymakers, the academe, the social work practitioners, and lastly, the social work students, because it will help them give new perspectives and also perspective and viewpoint on how to understand not just the victims, but also the doers of violence. For our scope and limitation of the study, our study is limited and also to male individuals who are reported to the authorities. They may be in cohabitation, intimate relationship, or a marriage. However, homogeneous relationship like women to women bond and men to men bond are not included.
Now, for the methodology of our study, this study employed the descriptive research design, particularly a qualitative research approach. For the unit of analysis, 8 male individuals in Davao City who have been reported to the authorities for committing domestic violence against women and children. Also, the in-depth interview guide was used for our research instrument, purposive sampling technique of 8 male individuals, thematic analysis for the data analysis, and also consent and confidentiality was used for our ethical considerations.